Hi, welcome to Laura's View and Tarot 2. I'm really glad you're here. Today's date is Wednesday, June 19th, 2024. And today we're going to look at the U.S. food supply. And thanks to a viewer of mine, Karen S., for posing this question. And she had a question involving the bioengineered food products. So let's look at a short compilation I've got that includes her question, and then we'll ask the universe for some insights and information. One second while I go to that share screen, you can see this compilation. If it interests you to pursue on your own, just click on the Facebook link that will be in the video description box. Okay, here is a link to a site that had a good article, I thought, that talked about the differences between GMOs and bioengineered foods. So items that of information. Now, when I was looking at this article, one thing that popped out at me is that food production must be increased if the world's population grows. Notice there's an if there. So proponents of GMO foods argue that without their use, there will not be enough food to meet the demands of future populations. This argument has some validity, but current techniques cannot expand production significantly. And the reality is that the primary reason for GMO and bioengineered foods is to generate profits for large corporations seeking even greater profits. Well, so corporations are going to corporate. So we know that. Now, I looked at a discussion site that was discussing GMO and bioengineered, and here was one anonymous comment. Just because an item is GMO does not mean it's inherently bad. Bioengineering has a bad rap. It's entirely possible to make crops that have higher yield, are resistant to pests, contain extra vitamins and antioxidants, are drought resistant, etc., that don't even have the potential to cause harm to humans using bioengineering. Yeah, it's all about the intent behind it. Okay, I agree with that. Karen S., here was her question in an email. I'm curious about bioengineered foods now appearing on food labels. Are they truly bioengineered and bad for us, or did they start labeling that way to make us more aware of foods that are not good for our health? And I would have taken this question just as it was, except for this. One of the big naughties, I think, in the world is the pharma companies. And I looked up the one that starts with PF. And sure enough, it has a significant presence in the food industry through its animal health division. The company is committed to ensuring a safe global food supply by providing innovative animal vaccines and prescription medicines to the livestock industry. But anyway, they're heavily involved with food production for our world. That scares me a little bit, especially from a company, pharmaceutical company, that has never, 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 never been behind a cure. Never. Their products are all about controlling aspects of a disease, but not in curing them. So I think what I'd like to do is do a comparison read. I'm using two decks because people have said before, even with just 10 cards, I've said I can still get a good variety of responses with comparisons. I'm going to use two decks. And the top deck is going to be giving us some advice and information about bioengineered food products in the United States. Then it's going to be comparing those with just the general food supply for the United States, the safety and nutritional value, etc. So we'll do a comparison read. Now, I'm going to let you watch me shuffle the cards, lay them out, and there'll be five cards on each level, each question, and this comparison, and we'll see which cards, if they look the same. I don't think the United States food supply, no matter whether it's bioengineered or not, is going to have very great, a very great look to it. We have so many products and chemicals that are allowed in United States of America foods that aren't allowed in the rest of the world. It's really troubling. In fact, I live just 12 miles away from New Brunswick. I often go over to buy my more processed type of foods, maybe cereal or something, just because there's less added ingredients, because Canada seems to have some of that umbrella protection that the European nations do. So not all of you live 12 miles away from Canada and can do that. So let's take a look at the food supply. Again, bioengineered versus just the general food supply. Let's see what the universe wants us to know. And in the meantime, be thinking of ways that you have learned to bless and raise the vibration, frequency, and quality of the food that you consume. And I'm going to invite everybody that does that in the comments for the YouTube channel. Please put those affirmations and guidelines in your comments and share them with others, because I truly believe we can do some very structural changes to our food supply in that way. And I know some of you feel the same way too and have some really great practices for it. Okay, I'm going to switch the camera. Let's watch me work with the cards and we'll find out together what this comparison looks like. Like I said, I'm not looking for anything too great on either row, but we'll find out how they differ. Okay, this top deck again is going to be giving us insights and information about bioengineered food products in the United States. If they are not giving us a heads up of, they may be better. We'll see. My viewer kind of wondered if they weren't showing us that there might be some better things out there. And certainly when you think of, they're kind of doing away with the GMO label and genetically modified, and switching it to calling it bioengineered. So, the distinction was semi lost on me as a novice to the subject, but I know there is one. But let's just look at bioengineered, because that is the current term that's in use for our food supply when there's been manipulation of the product, not just like selective breeding to get, fatter cattle or something like that, but truly some bioengineering going on. Okay, we'll have five cards in each row. Bioengineer, they got a nice first card. So we got the Strength, Page of Wands, Five of Swords, Queen of Swords, and last but not least, Temperance. Okay, now let's work with the general food supply in general deck. You'll notice I always work with the cards in camera without stopping it. I make sure the cards show up in the camera, and I truly am as surprised as you are by whatever shows up. We have the Lovers card showing up for the food supply, the Six of Wands, Queen of Pentacles, Judgment, and Page of Swords. Now, this is interesting. There's not a huge difference between the two, between bioengineered and the general food supply. There's nothing. I was expecting some cautions on the bioengineered food. It looks like they may actually have a little bit of white hat influence in cleaning it up from some of the nefarious products that have been inserted into the food supply. So my viewer may have been onto something actually, that we don't need to consider bioengineered foods to be the boogie men that we thought they were. So let's take a look. So the first card is our, just in general, what's, is it represented by? It's represented by Strength. So it looks like there's some good oversight going on with the bioengineering currently in process. And clarifying that, we have one of my white hat cards. Again, this is why I'm saying that the white hats seem to be involved in making sure that, I think this might be why we've had so many problems with food production plants and what have you. The white hats got involved and stepped in and removed some of the shenanigans that were going on. Hidden influence. Again, here we've got a, There's been some trickiness in this traditional reading of this card. It often, people think that the opponents have walked away in disgust or dismay, but it's like there's not a total victory to be had here is usually how it means to me. So it's not a confirmed and complete process by any means at all. And again, there is an element here of, as we know, you know, there were plans. Let's make them sick. Let's sell them medicine. So let's keep them alive long enough to sell them lots of medicine and then bring in a new crop of humans. The Queen of Swords is giving us our advice here. Now, the Swords is our written and spoken words, and it's kind of a contractual type of thing. So again, read your labels would be what the first thing I would think that she was trying to tell us. And again, think clearly. If you have an option to buy something at a farmer's market that's homegrown, go for that rather than the packaged or bioengineered options. The Temperance card is kind of our final one about the potential outcome if you do. You're going to see a moderate access to a decent food supply here in the United States if you watch your labels and labeling. You might want to avoid those vegetables that have been sprayed with that appeal product that Mr. Gates has put out there. But with care, reading labels, you don't have to run from something necessarily because it was a bioengineered product. Now, let's look at the food supply in general. The Lover's card is indicating it. So we've got two major arcanas for the food supply of the United States. I was not expecting, like I said, anything much in the way of positivity for the food supply in general. And we've got the clarifier here that there's been kind of a victory on that front for the food supply going on. And again, I think it's kind of hinting back to some of those issues that we've had in months and years past, the last couple of years with production facilities burning to the ground, what have you. It may have actually been white hat actions that were behind that. I'd heard that theory, but I hadn't read cards on it specifically myself. Now, our hidden influence card, Queen of Pentacles. Okay. Now, this is a card of peace, tranquility, satisfaction, and there's some generosity involved here. So again, white hats kind of watching out for us, making sure that they cleaned up some really nasty elements of our food supply as much as they could. The advice card here, judgment. Again, use your judgment. And it looks like it's even stronger here with the general food supply as far as advice goes than it was in the bioengineered line. So use good judgment on the products you buy. Read those ingredients, know what they are. Oh boy, recently I tried to buy some vitamins that didn't have manufactured B12 in them. I had to look long and hard. So look at your products, read the labels, be careful what you buy. Again, if you have a homegrown local option, always, you know, spend your money at home first, please. Always, always, always. And then the potential outcome. We've got the Page of Swords showing up for the potential outcome here. This one says moderate success, okay? Teamwork between consumer and producer can really have some good outcomes here. And with the Page of Swords showing up here for the, this is one about intelligence and truth. So again, there is information out there about labeling and ingredients. It's not always easy to decipher. There are also a number of food apps out there. I use one that checks the QR code for bug ingredients. So there's some good food tracker apps out there that you may want to use. Again, so read your labels, download those apps that help you avoid product ingredients you want to avoid, and be a smart consumer. But overall, it's looking like the food supplies had some cleanup going on to it. That gives me an idea for another read. So I'll keep that to myself and come back with that question that just popped into my head in another video. This is sufficient for this one. Let's recap. I was curious about the U.S. food supply because of an email I received from one of my viewers asking about it, specifically with a question that was fairly thought-provoking about bioengineered food elements that are now on the market. And I thought, well, in the United States, there's so many ingredients that aren't allowed in other countries in our food. It's really discouraging. And I thought, I think what I'd like to do is compare bioengineered food supply items that are bioengineered versus just the food supply in general for the United States, thinking that they may be similar, but they weren't going to be that great. Well, to my surprise, bioengineering food came up with a strength card kind of indicating it. And one of the reasons it did is because there's apparently been some white hat involvement in making sure that the bioengineered is actually going to be a benefit to those of us who are going to be the consumers of said products. Still some shenanigans going on. It's not totally cleaned up, okay? And the Queen of Swords advised us to use our smarts, use our intelligence, read labels, again, because this is the written spoken word. So read labels and just understand that if you do, and you're a careful consumer, you're going to have some moderate success in getting access to a decent quality level of food products, even in the bioengineered range. Now, for the food supply in general, we had the Lover's card show up, which is about balance and taking care of the needs and of one another, you know, equally. Nobody's better than the other. There's a lot of mutual concern and care going on here. And that was, again, we had a victory card show up for that, for the general food supply, which made me hark back to the production plants that have been raised and are no longer here. And I'd heard the theory that there was some cleanup involved with those. The card seemed to be really giving us a nod in that direction. The hidden influence card here, Queen of Pentacles, just there was care and concern for the quality and what was being added to the food or done to the food. So the needs of Americans was in consideration there. Advice card, use our good judgment. Okay, always read your labels. As I mentioned, there's a number of food apps out there that you can you scan your codes on your products and check for bug ingredients or whatever you might want to be trying to avoid in your food products that aren't just 100% one product only, like carrots or something. So feel free to download those and be the smartest consumer you can be. And then ultimately the outcome for the general food supply was indicated with the Page of Swords. Again, kind of a card, again, swords, written and spoken word, okay? And a card kind of truth. So there is truth to be had in the labeling and ingredients lists. It can't all be hidden, even if they do try to make it a little difficult to find, like it was when I was trying to find the B12 that was naturally sourced. Whew, what a project that was. Found some though, because I read labels and looked. Okay. Now, that's it for this video. So the American food supply isn't quite as yucky as I was afraid it was going to be. That was good to find out. Bioengineered foods don't necessarily have to be avoided, but use common sense in what you consume and what you buy and what you prepare for your family. And when you have a choice, shop local, shop low ingredient, and be a smart consumer. And again, I send out an invitation, I want to repeat it. If you have affirmations that you say over your food to have it have the highest possible vibration and benefit for your system, please share that in the comments so other people can too. I've read some really convincing stories of travelers. One blessed everything that he ate and drank, never got sick. The other one didn't and had issues. And overall health was much better in the one that did that. So those affirmations and blessings can really, really make a difference. So I invite you to share them. And I thank you so much for sharing your time with me as we explore this topic. If you're willing to receive it, until next time, I send you love, light, and I wish for you everything bright. Thank you.